May I request Dr. Hemant Malhotra, sir, to introduce our third pillar, Dr. Gopala Kavali. He is the main man behind this all inception of the idea.
Thank you, Lalit. And I think I would like to second what Dr. Girdhar Singh Bhati is saying. Like Girdhar and me, we have been in oncology for 30 years. And like it is also my firm conviction that the most important thing in cancer treatment is palliative care. And palliative care starts with the diagnosis of a patient, even in first stage. And thank you very much, Kavita, for a wonderful talk. And we're very proud to have you on our team.
Thank you, sir.
I'd like to welcome Dr. Gopala to the webinar. He's at the moment in Texas, USA. It must be very early in the morning for him. So Dr. Gopala, thank you for coming on board. And with your permission, we'll continue with the program. We're a few minutes late, but that usually happens when you have a program over several hours and several talks. So would you like to say something or should we continue, Dr. Gopala?
So, what is the next? I thought all the talks are over, right? Just my remarks and you.
We have an extremely important part, the panel discussion.
Okay, then I can actually say a few words and then move on to my job.
Sure. Then maybe after the discussion, Dr. Gopala can give his concluding remarks. So Lalit, back to you.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much. And thank you, Dr. Gopala, for joining us this early morning. So may I request Sindhu Nair? She is Assistant Nursing Superintendent.
Lalitji, how long is the panel discussion?
I mean, it's for half an hour, sir. 30
okay,
minutes.
Can I say a few words and then go?
We will love that if you can be with us for next 30 minutes or so.
I have a deliverable.
Okay. Right, sir. Please go ahead, sir.
Yeah. I don't take much time. I just wanted to thank all the speakers. By the way, it's me. You know, the photo you're seeing in the brochure also is me. That's a long time back. So what age does to all of us? Thank you all the speakers. Excellent talks. We all know the nurses are a very critical part of their care, especially in the oncology care. I know firsthand when my father was in the All Indian Medical Sciences being treated for leukemia. So I have firsthand appreciation for all the nurses. So this is my way of, you know, thanking back all the nurses by being part of the commemoration of World Nursing Day today, Nursing Month. Just Dr. Malhotra will be probably saying a few words about foundation, but you know, we have been doing several activities under the Carcinogenesis Foundation, and then this Dr. Malhotra is the president of the India chapter. Thank you, sir, for stepping up and you know, taking care of the India chapter for the past 1 year. We have many more events coming up. We are celebrating No Tobacco Day on 31st of May. We will communicate more details to you. Again, with this, Dr. Lalit, thank you very much for putting this wonderful program together and organizing it. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your kind words. With this, may I request Sindhu Nair to start the panel discussion.
I hope all my panelists have got connected. So
yes,
I take the pleasure of introducing my panelists before starting the panel discussion. So I introduce my panelists. The first to go is Ms. Renu Meena. She's from Bikaner and she works with the oncology department as a senior nursing faculty. She works with the Sardar Patel Medical College in Bikaner with over 20 years of experience. So welcome, Renu, to the panel discussion. Hi, Renu. You need to put your mic on.
Hanji, ma'am. Good evening, all respected panelists.
The next person is Kavita Sharma. She's from Jaipur. We just heard her. A beautiful talk, Kavita. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am.
She is the assistant nursing superintendent working with, at the moment, she works with Mahatma Gandhi Hospital and Medical College, Sitapura, Jaipur, and she has over 25 years of experience, and she has worked in various hospitals in various capacities, which includes palliative care and also has an experience in as a teaching faculty also. Welcome, Kavita, to the for the panel discussion.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
Hello to panel.
Thank you. Along with us, we have Surya Sukumaran from Rajiv Gandhi Cancer Hospital. A warm good evening to you, Surya. Hi, Surya. Surya, we can't hear you. She is a nurse educator. Good evening, Surya. She is a nurse educator who is working with Rajiv Gandhi Hospital. She is working with Rajiv Gandhi Hospital for, and she has also an experience of working with Fortis Hospital. She is a nurse educator with multiple initiatives taken over there. She has a vast experience of conducting a lot of conferences and continuing nursing education. We have along with us Ms. Shri Lekha Rajesh, who is the Chief Nursing Officer of RCC Trivandrum, the Regional Cancer Center Trivandrum. Welcome, Shri Lekha.
Good evening, ma'am.
Hi. She has got more than 25 years of experience working as a nursing faculty over there. She's also the recipient of the President's Award. Welcome, Shri Lekha, to the panel discussion.
Thank you, ma'am.
We go over to Colonel Madhumita. She is the Chief Nursing Director of Rajiv Gandhi Cancer Institute and Research Center. Welcome, Madam Madhumita.
Hi, good evening, everyone.
Hi. With over 25 years of experience in various faculty positions in various hospitals, at the moment, she's associated with Rajiv Gandhi Hospital. Welcome to each and everyone. I'm Sindhu Nair, Deputy Nursing Superintendent, associated with Tata Memorial Hospital for the last 8 years. I will be the moderator for this session. Well, going over to the session. Now, today's topic is nurses' role and scope of practice in the care of cancer patients. Well, successful cancer care requires a team approach, and knowledgeable oncology nurses play a crucial role in functioning of the team. The goal of reducing cancer incidences. The goal of reducing cancer incidences and improving survival for providing better palliative care cannot be met without the effort of these nurses. Well-prepared oncology nurse is the key to having a good oncology setup. अब मैं रीनू को पूछना चाहती हूँ कि आप इतने साल से oncology setup में काम करते हो, तो मैं ये पूछना चाहती हूँ कि आपने क्या देखा है कि क्या इस last 20 सालों में या 15 सालों में क्या क्या difference हुआ है clinical setting में?
Sorry for the interruption, ma'am. Do you have the lecture slides?
No, we don't have the lecture slides. Okay. It is just a panel discussion where all will be speaking extempo.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
So, मैं रेनू को पूछना चाहती हूँ कि आपने इस last थोड़े सालों में क्या difference देखा है अपने सेटअप में? पहले आप जब नॉविस नर्स होके आई थी, ऑनकोलॉजी सेटअप कैसा था और इतने सालों के एक्सपीरियंस में आपने क्या डेवलपमेंट देखा है ऑनकोलॉजी सेटअप में?
हाय, गुड इवनिंग मैम.
गुड इवनिंग.
रेनू मीना, मैं बीकानेर सरदार पटेल मेडिकल कॉलेज कैंसर हॉस्पिटल ऑनकोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट से. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मैम, मैं 6 मंथ से ऑन्कोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट में काम कर रही हूँ. अभी तक मैंने जितना देखा है, जितना मैंने जाना है ऑन्कोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट के, उस हिसाब से बताती हूँ. मेरा टॉपिक आज है रोल एंड स्कोप. एक्चुअली मैडम, पहले जो 3 सालों से पहले जो भी नर्सिंग कैंसर के लोग बारे में जो अवेयरनेस थी बहुत कम थी. आज अवेयरनेस है, बट बहुत ही रूरल गांव में बिल्कुल भी अवेयरनेस नहीं. हमारे पास पेशेंट्स आते हैं बीकानेर के आसपास के, बहुत बैकवर्ड एरिया के, बट हॉस्पिटल में आने के बाद उनके, हमारा यही प्रयास होता है, हमारी यही रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी होती है. फर्स्ट ऑफ पेशेंट्स का असेसमेंट करते हैं, पेशेंट्स के एजुकेशन है, कोऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ केयर है, डायरेक्ट पेशेंट्स केयर है या सिम्टम्स मैनेजमेंट है, सपोर्टिव केयर है, ये हम उनको बताते हैं. उनको इस बार के लिए अवेयर कराते हैं कैंसर के की बहुत बड़ी बीमारी नहीं है, और बहुत से लोग आगे बढ़कर अपने पेशेंट्स का अच्छे से ट्रीटमेंट करवाते हैं, अच्छा रिजल्ट, अच्छा ट्रीटमेंट ले रहे हैं. हमारी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी क्या है, हम पेशेंट्स को असेसमेंट करें, फिजिकली साइकोलॉजी सपोर्ट, उनका इमोशनल स्टेटस है, क्या पास्ट हेल्थ हिस्ट्री है, पेशेंट का जो
हेलो मैम मिस रीनू हैज जस्ट लॉग्ड आउट.
ओके लेट मी मूव ओवर टू द नेक्स्ट पैनलिस्ट. मे बी accidentally she must have logged out, maybe she will log in once again. Okay, now as Renu was telling that in a village or in a background it's very difficult to reach out to the nurses because of the setup. So may I ask Kavita that yes. In which way, how can we empower those nurses to reach out, how can we reach out to the nurses over there, how can we empower them in a better decision making, because obviously it is not as easy as it as in a urban setting to reach out to the nurses in a rural setting.
Yes ma'am. जो आपने अभी रेनू से क्वेश्चन किया था कि मतलब कैसा इतना आपका एक्सपीरियंस रहा, जो मेरा एक्सपीरियंस रहा है वो इन सालों में कि पहले के टाइम पे कैंसर में इतनी अवेयरनेस नहीं थी, लोग बाग इतना जानते नहीं थे. धीरे धीरे लोग बाग जाने लगे तो फैसिलिटीज कम होती गई, लोग वहां तक पहुंच नहीं पा रहे थे. अब लोग पहुंच पाते हैं तो ट्रीटमेंट नहीं कराते हैं, ट्रीटमेंट कराने में उनको बहुत ज्यादा हैवी लगता है कि इतना महंगी दवाई है, इतना लंबा ट्रीटमेंट चलेगा, थक जाते हैं लोग बाग. इवन ये कंडीशन आ जाती है कि ना लॉन्ग ट्रीटमेंट होने की वजह से फैमिली मेम्बर्स भी है ना परेशान हो जाते हैं. बट पैलेटिव केयर के माध्यम से अगर हम पेशेंट्स को केयर देते हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं मुझे ये फील होता है एज अ नर्स कि पेशेंट को हम बेटर केयर दे सकते हैं उसके एंड ऑफ द लाइफ टाइम में. क्योंकि मैं डे टू डे कई बार पेशेंट्स को देखती हूँ कि मतलब पेशेंट्स का फोर्थ स्टेज में डायग्नोसिस है, यंग पेशेंट्स हैं जिनको मतलब 32 इयर्स 22 इयर्स है, उनका डायग्नोसिस ही फोर्थ स्टेज में हुआ है, उनका कोई ट्रीटमेंट नहीं हो सकता, ना उनकी सर्जरी हो सकती है, ना उनको रेडियोथेरेपी दी जा सकती है, ना उनको कीमोथेरेपी दी जा सकती है. तो लास्ट में उनके पास रहता है सिर्फ पैलेटिव केयर, और उस पैलेटिव केयर के माध्यम से हम उनको ट्रीटमेंट देते हैं, टैबलेट्स देते हैं, पर धीरे धीरे उनका जो पेन की इंटेंसिटी वो इतनी ज़्यादा बढ़ जाती है कि अपन को लास्ट मॉर्फिन पे आना पड़ता है. और मॉर्फिन देने के बाद वो पेशेंट एक तरह से अचेत ही हो जाता है. तो इसको हम कह सकते हैं कि पिन ड्रॉप साइलेंट डेथ हो गई है, पेशेंट को हमने रिलीफ मतलब पेनलेस डेथ दे दी. और एम्पावर में अगर हम नर्सेस के पास फैसिलिटी नहीं है, नर्सेस आना नहीं चाहती हैं, इस फील्ड में ही नहीं आना चाहते कि हम कैंसर में जाना ही नहीं चाहते. जैसा कि मैंने मेरी प्रेजेंटेशन में कहा कि मैंने अपने डिपार्टमेंट में लोगों को भागते हुए देखा है, नर्सेस को, कि नहीं नहीं हमें ऑनको में काम नहीं करना, ऑनको से हमारी लाइफ खराब हो जाएगी, जो पेशेंट्स को कीमोथेरेपी के लॉस होते हैं वो हमें होंगे, जो रेडियोथेरेपी से लॉस होते हैं वो हमें होंगे. मैंने कहा अगर आप अपना डेडिकेशन दोगे, स्पेशलिटी दोगे, तो आपको आगे बहुत ज्यादा इसके अंदर एडवांस है, बहुत अपॉर्चुनिटीज है इसके अंदर, और बहुत ज्यादा इसके अंदर आपको बेनिफिट्स मिलेंगे लाइफ में. क्योंकि आपको कई लोगों से कई बीमारियां ऐसी, कार्डियक है, न्यूरो है, जिसमें पेशेंट आता है और चला जाता है, उससे कोई इंट्रैक्शन नहीं रहता. गायनी के पेशेंट आए, बच्चा हुआ और चले गए. लेकिन कैंसर का पेशेंट डे वन से, जब से उसकी फाइल बनती है तब से वो हमारे अटैचमेंट रहता है और टिल डेथ तक रहता है. तो उसकी आदतों के बारे में
तो कविता मैं ये पूछना चाहती हूँ कि आपने बताया कि हमारे आपने बताया कि काफी सारे नर्सेस उतने स्ट्रॉन्ग भी होते हैं, उन लोग आपने एक सेंटेंस यूज किया कि वो भाग जाते हैं. तो मैं ये पूछना चाहती हूँ कि हम हमारे नर्सेस को स्ट्रॉन्ग कैसे करें ताकि वो डट के उनका सामना करें.
मैम उनको प्रॉपर एजुकेशन दी जाए, जो एज ए ट्रेनिंग टाइम में वो आते हैं उनको ट्रेनिंग टाइम के अंदर बेटर एजुकेशन दी जाए, उन्हें सिखाया जाए कि ये चीज अपन करते हैं नर्सेस को, उनको इस तरह से मेंटली ट्रेन किया जाए ताकि उनका मानस है वो क्लियर रहे कि हमें पेशेंट की केयर करनी, फोकस उस पर रहे उनका, ना कि रेदर उनको बेनिफिट्स दिए जाए, फाइनेंशियली बेनिफिट्स दिए जाए, उनको टाइमिंग दी जाए, उनके टाइमिंग शॉर्ट, उनको अलाउंसेस दिए जाए ताकि उनका एक इंटरेस्ट भी बने और दूसरा उनका पेशेंट्स के साथ अटैचमेंट अच्छा हो तो बेटर केयर कर सके.
वेरी ट्रू, थैंक यू वेरी मच कविता. नाउ गोइंग ओवर एंड टेकिंग ओवर फ्रॉम व्हाट कविता हैज टोल्ड दैट द नर्सेस हैव टू बी ट्रेन्ड वेल, ओके, उनको एजुकेशन देनी चाहिए. So I would like to, now education comes from the basic and education has to be, oncology nursing in clinical setting starts from the basic in the education system. Now with the vast experience in administration of running the regional cancer center, may I, sorry, may I ask Ms. Srilekha that what changes can be brought about in the nursing education system to better our nursing practice and clinical service?
Thank you, ma'am. Nursing education in India is governed through Indian Nursing Council at the national level and also through the state nursing councils at the state level. This INC advises government on nursing matters, prescribes nursing education syllabus, specifies minimum quality criteria for education institutions. And also this state nursing council inspect and accredit training institution, conduct examinations, monitor rules of professional conduct and maintain an active register of nurses. So I feel that there is a gap in nursing sector between service and academia is wide. As per the industry experts, just 30% of BS in nursing graduate today are employable and possess the requisite skills to get privileged to work independently. And usually the hospitals spend 3 to 6 months and incur high training cost to make undergraduate trained nurses job ready, often suffer loss in terms of return on investment due to high attrition rates among nurses, especially within the first few years of training. As a CNO of the cancer center, I often felt that most of the undergraduate trained nurses joining the services are not immediately employable. Induction training, as all of you know, is mandatory. Apart from this, these hospitals are strained in conducting training for several months to enhance the skill of this newly hired nurse before they are deemed to be adequately qualified to deploy to patient care. They can be given privileges accordingly only. So we often suffer loss in terms of investment due to high attrition rate and training cost. As a clinical nurse, I would suggest a few changes that may incorporate into the existing system to overcome this hurdle. First of all, integration of nursing education and service in India will help in enhancing student learning and facilitate meaningful links between theory and practice. Though this knowledge exchange occurs between educational institute and the service area where the students are placed, the dual role notification from Indian Nursing Council in the year 2019 is issued with this aim. That has been made into practice. The concept paper attached as part of this notification is extracted from different success models in practice from some of the institutions of the country. The nurse educators to spend time in clinical practice, updating their clinical skills and re-experience the realities of practice. That may be one of the ways. We may start from the level of educators, mandate clinical experience of working in hospital for becoming a nurse teacher. Exposure and experience in working in hospitals coupled with comprehensive teachers training will better equip this faculty to teach the student nurses. For existing nurse teachers in academics without clinical exposure, certification programs can be introduced. And also another thing I would suggest that faculty exchange programs, this can be done through bi-directional exchange agreements, visiting faculties at national and international level and conducting of classes online in agreements with foreign universities. Indian nurses are prepared to serve at the international level. These trans-cultural exchanges definitely will add to their competencies and vision. For example, MOU of Indian Nursing Council with University of Houston College of Nursing with regard to nurse practitioner in critical care is an example for this. There are such many faculty exchange programs are done in many state councils that has to be extended to all of India. And the thing is high fidelity simulations. Simulations are getting wider acceptance in nursing education system where concept of patient safety and consumer protection are absent. The concept of sisters becoming teachers have to be modified. Anyone and everyone cannot be a teacher. In order to provide exemplary education, students have to be taught by qualified and specialized nurse educators. Provision of simulation training, especially in specified skilled areas, need to be implemented at undergraduate level. Simulations need to be given in opportunities for students to reflect themselves through adequate debriefing after the simulation exercises. The nurse educators need to develop and standardize appropriate evaluation tools for these simulation programs. And the thing in oncology nursing is nurse practitioners in oncology can be prepared to function in tertiary care settings. rigorous educational preparation will enable the nurses to diagnose and treat patients with cancer, as well as preventive and promotive care relevant to cancer. They can contribute in patient selection and admission to ICU and discharge, problem identification through appropriate assessments, selection and administration of medication or devices or therapies, patient education for the use of therapeutics, evaluation of knowledge of interaction of therapeutics, recognition and management of complications. So introduction of such a program in oncology can improve our practice. Another thing is interprofessional education and training in healthcare. I would suggest that for early sensitization and familiarization of students from various professional courses like BS in nursing, MBBS, and other allied health courses in India, a module should be included in the first year of curriculum of undergraduate health professional courses to educate students on roles, responsibilities, sensitivities, boundaries of each and every healthcare professionals. Doctors and nurses should be sensitized to respect each other as partners to help remove disparity and antipathy towards each other in the healthcare profession. Introduce interprofessional cases in the final year of undergraduate professional courses where students from various disciplines can come together and work in hands-on in a clinical setup. This exposure will help nurses effectively to function as a member in the multidisciplinary team. In case of oncology nursing, they can be a part of multidisciplinary tumor board also. This experience will enhance their contributions to such field. And the thing is high-tech and low-touch, high-touch approach. With this present-day nursing education is preparing students to maintain human element of nursing care with the help of sophisticated technology, that is introduction of patient care and evidence-based practices, quality improvement, then use of information technology in nursing practice, especially with regard to hospital information system, electronic health record. Now robotics is there in curriculum to accustom students to such a system early when they are a student itself. For enhanced adoption of technology in nursing education and practice, it is critical to train the faculty also so that they can leverage technology to teach and train. Then another thing is e-learning courses. So during this COVID pandemic situation, there won't be regular classroom education. So e-learning opportunities can be given. There are certain e-learning courses which are offered by Infusion Nursing Society, Indian Nursing Council, World Council of Endothermal Therapists. All these will give major input to student nurses so that they can extend their knowledge background. And also over the past few years, there are dramatic increase in the newer nursing roles within oncology. There are certain specialties which a nurse can manage with essential training in oncology, less nurse-led clinic, which is a major initiative, which can give a rehabilitative, supportive, and symptom management to cancer patients. Lymphedema care, stoma care, brachytherapy nursing, head and neck postoperative rehabilitation, insertion of central venous catheters are all can be developed as a subspecialty. In our center, it has been made as a subspecialty. And short-term training in all these courses, if given to nurses, they will improve their academic background as well as their skill in providing care to the patient. And the thing is, post-registration, I feel that most of the BSc and MSc graduates are reported to move predominantly to educational position in the public and private sectors. Why? Because many countries where clinical nursing carries a low status, as they think academic qualification are valued as a potential route of clinical practice into higher status and better paid jobs in education. So remuneration and job position are to be designed in such a way that nurses with higher qualification are placed in better position in clinical settings. Such highly qualified nurses in clinical setting definitely will improve the scope of practice in nursing. And also, apart from the basic education, we need to strengthen our in-service education program. And majority of the accredited hospital has a mandatory training program, but others have to come up with this. Our nursing council has to give mandatory CN credit hours to such training program, which will definitely empower our nurses. So I feel that there is a need to broaden the scope of nursing curriculum by adding more concepts like competency-based model. I would suggest that competency-based model and critical thinking among nurses, which is surely empower nurses to act as a backbone in the hospital, surely to oncology nursing services also.
Thank you very much, Srilekha. That was a very in-depth understanding what we have got of your concept for us to amalgamate the education system to the clinical services. may I put forth the next question to Madam Madhumita? The scenario of treatment to oncology setting is changing. So along with that changes the adaptation of nursing services too. So now how we have understood that the amalgamation is important. For example, Madam Kavita has told that log bhag jate hai, they are not keen to working because they're afraid of certain things. So Madam Madhumita, with a background and of Army as well as the head of regional cancer center, can you please tell me what are the different roles of oncology nursing? Do we envisage for nurses in the Indian scenario so that we can attract them when the attrition rate can be reduced?
Yeah. Thank you, Sindhu. Over the last few decades, we have seen that the cancer care has come a long way from the general nursing care for the patients with cancer using primary care at the bedside and comfort measures to the development of the oncology nursing as a specialist, as a specialty, you know, and this has been as a specialty and this with a defined knowledge. The nurses are now, oncology nurses have specific knowledge about oncology and they are supported by research and expert practice. Now, oncology nurses, they are professionals, you know, with a vast experience and they have a very diversified role. They work with a multidisciplinary team and they work in a wide variety of sectors. Like if you take in community or in OPD, they take care of patients. They focus on cancer screening. They focus on detection of cancer and in prevention. Whereas in hospital scenario, they take care of the patients who are suffering from cancer. They become a communicator and an educator as a counselor to the families of the patients, you know, who are suffering from cancer. Then they care for patients who are cancer survivors, and also they provide care at the end of life. Not only this, they also are, you know, working in hospice care. They are working in radiation therapy facilities. They are working in standalone facilities. They are working in private oncology clinics. They also work as home care, healthcare with along with home healthcare agencies. They are also working at and giving care at home level also. So, you know, the nurses, they really have a diverse role. You just cannot say that oncology nursing role is limited to one. No, their role starts from prevention till, you know, till the treatment and end of life care. So as we see that the healthcare system is changing, you know, and new scientific discoveries are integrated into the cancer care. So the role of oncology nurse is continuously evolving. You know, new roles are coming up and new dimensions are coming up for the oncology nurse. So if you want to tell me that, yes, if I want to see how the Indian scenario should focus on for the oncology nurses, then as Shilekha also said that, yes, we should emphasize on various certificate courses which should be made available to the nurses so that they become a certified pediatric oncology nurse, or they may become a pediatric hemato-oncology nurse, or they can become a blood and marrow transplant certified nurse. They can become certified breast care nurse, or they can even become advanced oncology certified nurse. And also along with this, you know, we should encourage and we should allow the nurses like to become, we should emphasize on oncology research nurse, like oncology research nurse, you know, they coordinate with the clinicians for a clinical research purpose. They guide the patients. They coordinate with the patients, follow the follow-up care. They coordinate with them. They educate the patients with the, you know, the new medicines, the study medicines, what are happening. They go with the clinical trials. Even we should emphasize on oncology nurse practitioner. Then we should have oncology nurse navigator. See, oncology nurse navigator is very important. This practice is there abroad. So, but we should, in India, we should also try to inculcate this. Why? Because oncology nurse navigator, she is a link between the nurse, between the patient, and between the multidisciplinary team members. You know, she helps the patient in when the moment the patient is diagnosed, she helps the patient to link with the different consultants so that the patient's treatment is smoothly taken care of. Then she helps in the follow-up care and so forth. Then the nurses should be encouraged as radiation oncology nurse. And a new thing which has come up, which is there in Australia, is breast care nurse. You know, this breast care nurse, they are registered nurses who have specialized and have vast experience and knowledge in breast cancer and breast care nursing. And they play a significant role in taking care of patients who have suffered from breast cancer. And obviously, clinical nurse specialists. So this is what I think we should look into if we want our nurses really to grow in a super speciality area. Thank you.
Very true, ma'am. Very true. Thank you very much for the roles, what you have mentioned to us. I'm sure the people who are listening to us will be spellbound with the extended and the expanded roles, what you have mentioned, so that many more nurses will be interested in taking up oncology, and that is going to be the future ahead. Now, taking over from here, and with the amalgamated issues and the mentions, what you all have told, that is what Madam Kavita, Madam Madhumita, and what Shileka has told us, what I have understood is that training and capacity building is the most important foundation of any institute. To train and induct novice nurses requires a systematic effort. And also what requires is to continue the training of the nurses who are working with us. So may I ask Ms. Surya to provide us an insight on better or innovative training techniques for novice nurses and also for the nursing staff working in hospital for improving the patient outcome related to oncology. Over to Surya.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for the question. So as the previous panelists were discussed, oncology nursing is a specialized area of nursing in which the nurse may require specialized practice as well as skill and knowledge to care the patient or to provide best care to the oncology patients throughout their cancer journey. As we have already discussed, the cancer journey starts with the time the patient goes with the diagnosis. Even the nurse has role in preventive as well as screening aspect of cancer as well. So till the end of life care, the nurse is responsible to provide appropriate care to the patient. But when we have a novice nurse into oncology, which is an alarming situation to the oncology nurse, without providing proper education, proper skills, we might not expecting them to handle a patient independently because they are having zero experience in nursing. They might not be having knowledge regarding oncology as well because oncology may be a new entity for them. So there may be many gray areas for them into oncology. So whenever we will be looking into these new budding nurses, the novice nurses, I must say, which is one of my favorite category also because teaching them, providing skills for them and expecting the same to practice at bedside for a novice nurse is very, very easy because she doesn't have a previous burden of experience, what I say. So we have to pay special attention when we plan any training program for the new novice nurse because as we already said, they are having zero experience, zero exposure in patient care. So when any nurse coming to any hospital, we will be focusing upon an onboarding induction program. So induction program must involve a basic cancer care curriculum for the novice nurse so that she will be sensitized. What is the role expected out of her when she will be at patient bedside? How can she able to identify the needs of the patient? How can she satisfy the needs or how can she meet the need of her patients when she will be assigned with patients? So this sensitization should happen at the induction phase itself. It also has to focus on the enhancement of the skill and knowledge as well, especially in terms of handling of chemotherapy, administration of the chemotherapy, knowledge into the chemotherapy to drugs and spill management. These are the practical entities we need to look into when we'll be conducting an induction program for any noviceness also. And other next focus has to be on the practical aspect of procedures. The other case, what we need to provide to a patient, that has to be ensured in the induction phase itself. As Sri Lekha ma'am already said, simulation is the best way of conducting the practical trainings before we send them to the patient bedside, so that they will be able to understand their own competency levels, and they might be having a knowledge how they will be performing the same patient bedside. So they will also know as to improve their knowledge as well as the skill. So mentorship or preceptorship program is the next thing that will be helping a novice new nurse to cope up with the oncology nursing care, because when she will be at patient bedside expecting to provide patient care to the cancer patients, so she is not having experience, just because of which she might not be able to fulfill the complete needs of a patient. So mentorship program, we will be assigning a senior nurse with the new nurse, so that the senior nurse will be always there to help the new nurse in the different care continuum of a patient, and the new nurse can also learn from the senior, and she can also pursue the skills from the senior nurse. So this will also help a new novice nurse to cope up with the cancer care of a patient. Next is competency-based continuing education, which is an important key to improve the skill and knowledge of an oncology nurse, which also focus on enhancing the practical as well as the skill of a nurse also. So when we'll be doing this competency assessment, we can able to understand the gap in actual nursing practice, what is expected out. So this way we can identify the training needs, and we can fulfill that training needs by which the new nurse will be having enhancing her knowledge as well as the skills what she requires to fulfill the need of a patient throughout their cancer care, which is also an important thing to follow when we will be sending a new nurse to bedside. And continuing nursing education is also having a great effect on enhancing the new skills, which has been upgrading in terms of drug, in terms of skill, in terms of other practical aspects of patient care, which can be by on-job training, which can be by conferences, which can be by some other training programs. Nursing tumor board is also having a great value in improving the nursing skill as well as knowledge, because the difficult cases what we can discuss in nursing tumor board, and the new nurses, the on-board nurses also will get knowledge on the same, and this will also help both the nurses, like new as well as the old nurses, to enhance their practice. So this is all from my side regarding the question. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Surya. Thank you very much. As Surya has mentioned, getting trained is very important. And one of the things which COVID-19 pandemic has taught us or has given us, we have got re-engaged in adult training. For example, what has happened today is a beautiful outcome of COVID-19 pandemic. We all have got connected from throughout India and across globally. If it was not COVID-19 pandemic, we would have to meet people personally. We would have to wait for a conference to come up. Over here, the pandemic had to hit us just to inform us that we can have webinars every month. We can have Zoom meetings every month. We can have online certificate course, which is much more feasible without meeting and flying across interstate to meet people. So this is a beautiful outcome and a positive outcome of the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, just to summarize what we all, the panelists, the esteemed panel members have spoken, let me just go through point by point. We need to find out ways to reach each and every nurse across the country. And this is what Madam Kavita has mentioned. And as Madam Sri Lekha mentioned, to amalgamate nursing education to service, to have better nursing educators to teach them better. And one of the beautiful sentences which I heard from Madam Madhumita was oncology nurse navigator or sutradhar. That is what I understood. That is to link the patient to a better, for a better patient outcome, for a better follow-up. I'm sure that will have a better positive outcome. to conduct online or certificate courses so that we can reach out to more and more nurses across the country so that we can improve the nursing services across. And to introduce, we may have to introduce, there is no other way out. With the last 2020 gone and 2021 also going, I think clinical services of the nursing education is going to be badly hit. The clinical services may have to introduce high fidelity simulators to improve the training services across our institutions. Thereby, I thank each and every panel member and also the organizers, especially Dr. Lalit Sharma, who got connected with us. Thank you very much. Thank you, Madam Madhumita, Surya, Kavita Sharma, Renu, and Madam Shrileka for the inputs which you have given to the panel. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sindhu. Thank you, Dr. Lalit.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Madhumita ji. Thank you, Sindhu ji, Shrileka ji, Surya ji, Kavita ji. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks to you all. And I think it's a beginning. And as Sindhu has rightly mentioned, that COVID has taught us a lot of things. So I think we can have more and more of such virtual meetings and we learn from each other. At least for me, it was a great learning experience. And I have conducted first webinar purely managed by the nurses, in fact, this time. So I'm so much thankful and grateful to you all for your excellent inputs. And we hope that in future, we will have more and more meetings. With this, we end up this meeting. And I thank Pankti and Roshni and Rajesh Sharma and the MICE IDEA teams for helping us. I thank my co-directors, Dr. Hemant Malhotra and Professor Gopala Kavali for helping us. I thank all my foreign faculty for sparing their time in the early morning hours. And with this, we end up this meeting. And thank you so much all and have a safe stay ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Bye-bye, Tata.
Bye, sir.